Hello, this is the RPG Chick.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Of course.
Okay, I know the answer to this, and it might not be the only way, but we have to let...
Hi. Greetings, my subject.
Yeah. We have to let Tut-Tut go first.
About this game?
Yeah.
Off we go. You start.
Okay. So this is my solution. There might be different ways, but I found out that this way worked, and I don't feel like exploring any other configurations. So here we go. We take this one. Let me take this whole row here. Now we're down to that. We take that. And basically gotta go down the line. All that. Is that gonna work? Actually, no. The last, we take two at the end. Yep. Ha!
That is... No.
That is awesome.
Come on, you have to take a marble.
But that would mean I have lost.
You got that right.
Yep, that's exactly what it would mean.
But I never lose.
Until now.
It certainly would be better that way. What would your people say if the godlike pharaoh were to lose against a mere mortal?
They must never find out.
You could bribe me with something.
Never mind, there's no people.
Yes, or I could have you squashed by my golem.
A bribe? Excellent idea.
Aha! Of course. I just came up with that. What would you like?
The Book of the Dead?
See.
It's yours.
Hooray.
In exchange, you won't tell anyone that I watched the temple virgins when they were changing.
Agreed.
We said that at the end. We can't actually talk to him?
What could I?
Alright, so we're gonna take this then. And we're going to actually take this then. Thank you. And we're going to take it.
The Book of the Dead. So what now?
Just missing the compass now.
Yep, we go bye-bye.
To the Red Pirate.
Ta-da!
What could I...
we can't say goodbye to him.
Ivo?
Yes?
See you later.
Okay.
See ya. Oh, wait. Oh, whatever. I keep forgetting about that other way out. What, you need an engraved invitation? These guys always come on together. I don't know what the deal is. Just want to make sure I don't leave anyone behind, you know?
Away we go.
Where is it again? Here. Tugator.
Cast off.
Huh? Look at that. Critter? Critter.
Meat.
Well, you're already... Yes, you're already sitting at the table. So how are you here?
Nate thought it'd be too dangerous on the island for me and the child. And for just once, I think he's right.
Okay.
The boys should be able to cope without me, I hope.
Well, there's only one boy, because Critter is, well, he is kind of there, I don't know.
Not only is she blessed with an appetite.
Alright, let's go see if we can get this compass from him somehow.
A quite fierce, grim-looking ape is preventing that.
Alright.
He's got the key. I don't want to get into a fight with him.
He's got the key. He's got secret. Book of the Dead. Let me look at this thing.
This thing weighs a ton. Wouldn't the pamphlet have been better?
The pamphlet of the dead hardly sounds as intimidating. Oh. Could we get in there like this?
Just look at that. Thinks he's something special, just because he beat up a fully grown man.
Mm.
A quite fierce, grim-looking ape is preventing that.
Alright, let's take this off, because I'm gonna go blind here. Okay, what can I do with anything? Let's go visit our friend here.
Perhaps you could help me again?
Shush!
No, okay. Okay, so I doubt any of these items are going to be any help. I mean, I already tried some of them. Can I interact with anything here? Alright, let's see if Critter has any objects that might be useful. Oh, the time turner thing. Maybe that would work on the monkey. We didn't have that before. Let's see, only has this spark of life thingy. Okay, let's bring him back on board and get this stuff. So, oh wait, it's not her, duh. Give Nate the time manipulator.
Thank you.
So, just in case.
Thank you.
Give him everything.
Thank you.
No.
What's up? Okay, see ya.
I just wanted to give him this, and I didn't actually pick it up.
Thank you.
Now, will she give him the spark of life thingy? No, she doesn't have the option to do that. Okay. Nay, hate! So, I doubt he's interested in this stuff, because we had this before, right? Fight with a monkey.
There's a saying about people who bring knives to gunfights, and I don't even have a knife.
Yeah. Alright. Oh yeah, stop time. Ha, sweet.
Got the key.
Right, it only works for a certain amount of time. Take the key. I've got the key.
Is this what you're looking for?
I've got secret.
I would think again if I were you. Think about it. How did I get the key? With magic.
Yeah.
Look what magic can do. Do you want to be stuck in a pink tutu and forced to be Chantel's playmate? Run! I'll give you 10 seconds head start.
Run. Awesome. Shiny door key.
The key to the Red Pirate's palace.
Use key on door, or we're just gonna go automatically through?
It's me again.
Banana.
Don't move. How did you get past the ape?
With skill and ingenuity.
Maybe the invisible powers helped me.
Take that back.
Nice and easy now. I don't want any trouble. And you've still got the head. I just wanted to hang out with my old friends. Right, guys?
My mom always told me I should get a head.
Okay. They're all I've got left.
I'd better not.
Give me that. Give me a compass.
If I steal the compass, I'll have old Red and his menagerie at my throat. It'd be better if he gave it to me of his own free will.
Yeah, but the menagerie's gone. Huh.
I gotta make him give me the compass, and quickly, and then get out of here. Old Red's a powder keg.
Stop time on him.
If I steal the compass, it'd be better. I gotta make him give me old Red's.
Key, hammer, hammer. See, what am I supposed to do? What if I change into this and then talk to him?
I gotta make him. Oh, Red's a powder keg.
I don't know why we had this outfit in the first place. Frame rate hits. I'm having trouble selecting things because the frame rate is so stinky right now. I don't know. I mean, there's two objects we can interact with. Well, three. There's something we gotta do with this statue. No, not the key. You think you could hammer and chisel on the statues or something like that? That'd be cool.
If I steal the it'd be better.
Alright, I'm not sure what we can do in here.
I better not. Not only is she blessed with an appetite.
Wish I could ask the other two for clues, for hints or something like that.
Ivo?
Yes?
Nope.
See you later.
Okay, see ya.
Hey, Critter.
Huh?
You take over for a bit. I've got some thinking to do.
Flutsuluka right off the ship. Okay, I gotta fool around off screen here. I'm not sure what to do next. So, I'll be back. Okay. I was really close. Shut up. Kulalabu. Come on, Nihate. Wah. I was close to what I was trying to accomplish. What we need to do is do both of the things I was doing or trying to do.
I gotta make him get old Red's a powder.
Okay, I did select this. Thank you.
Did William just move?
Huh? Don't know. Did he?
Why shouldn't he? Living friends. Friends living. Friends move, right?
Nah.
He did move.
Ha!
Who moved?
William. He wants to tell me something.
You mean that stone statue wants to tell you something? This could turn out badly for you.
Badly?
Yeah, you turned him into stone, right? Perhaps him and the others didn't really like that. And how are you going to protect yourself? They're stone already.
Oh, I won't let them out of my sight.
Don't blink.
Nah.
Better.
So, yeah, we gotta keep doing this.
Time to have some fun.
Whoop. Ah. That one's twerking or something.
No! No! What do you want from me?
They want you dead. Run!
They want you dead. I'll try and stop them. Run!
Cool.
That worked better than I dared hope.
Alright, all that's left is to take the compass.
Spirit compass. Now we've got the Book of the Dead, the compass, and the spark of life. Everything we need to bring Alistair back. To the Oracle!
To the Oracles. Poor Red Pirate, though. He feels more betrayed and abandoned than before.
Lassam, Aerith, Barium, Excetric.
Good. And now the spark of life!
Yeah, she has it.
Up to now, he's always known what he's doing. Let's hope it stays that way.
Just take a look around a little. Look at the Archmage Frog. Oh, he is sitting there. You can barely see him.
We've placed the frog on the compass, and I've read out the correct magic spell from the Book of the Dead. Just missing the spark of life now. We've played just... Not while the Archmage is still a frog. Not while...
I was looking for extra things that they can say, but...
It didn't work.
What happened?
Archmage Alistair!
Now he's a talking frog.
Why am I a frog?
Yeah, why is he still a frog?
We've brought his spirit back into this world. Turning him human again was never part of the deal.
What deal? But
there is a simple way to change our a deal? Frog back into a human being. It just needs to be kissed by a virgin princess.
Well, are you?
Where are we going to find one of them?
She is.
Up to now, he's always... Not while the... I did not do the sex thing!
Really? Then prove it!
Awesome. I did not do the sex thing.
I admit it. I couldn't have managed this without Nate and Critter. The Oracle was right.
but now it's my turn. I admit it, but now...
Here goes nothing. That proves it to you, Nate.
Oh, thank you.
But I don't understand. Why is Ivo pregnant?
That's what Ivo doesn't understand.
Huh?
The artifact of divine fate can fulfill any wish, and Ivo carried it for a long time.
Oh.
If one spends enough time in the presence of such a powerful magical object, then the magic can linger. It keeps working, even when the object itself isn't there anymore.
But I didn't wish for a child.
I'm not saying you did.
Oh.
Well, yes, I...
Nehate.
You did this to me? You wanted to start a family with me.
Aw.
Yes, but I didn't know. Ivo of the Woodland Realm, will you be my wife and spend the rest of your life with me?
Yes, yes!
Aww.
Congratulations to both of you.
I actually hate Nate less now.
Soon we'll be a real family. And we didn't even have to have that sex thing to do it.
That's a good thing, though.
Yeah, great.
Now, tell me, what has happened?
You were changed into a frog, don't you remember?
You were changed into a frog by the little Van Buren.
There was a golem. Munkus.
Right.
He tricked Wilbur, but you sorted out the golem in seconds, and Munkus wouldn't have been a problem for you either.
But then there was this incredible magical energy. It caught me completely by surprise.
That was the little brat. She'd got hold of Wilbur's wand, and because she's a descendant of the evil sorcerer that made the wand...
Wilbur's magic wand is the wand of... May the gods protect us.
The Elder Wand.
She transformed half of Seastone. And she's been here, too. I've seen some wizardry in my life, but what this girl's been up to... Whoa, Nelly.
Where are Wilbur and Remy?
We only think Remy is dead. The one posing as Remy is actually Munkus, who, is, unfortunately, is not dead. Well, Remy is dead. Let me just answer his questions.
I'm so sorry, Archmage, but... Remy is dead. He was killed by a ghost.
He's... No, I can still feel him.
Yeah, he's still with
he
us.
He died in Wilbur's arms, in the temple in which he found Wilbur's magic wand all those years ago.
Which temple is that?
I don't know exactly. Wilbur thought it was dedicated to some evil god. He called him the Nameless One.
The Nameless One.
You know.
So that's not very good.
Some sorcerers held rituals there and built a machine.
The wand. It went from the Van Buren's to Wilbur via Remy and then to the Van Buren girl. I should have examined it more closely.
Are you feeling okay? You look washed out.
Are you feeling all right, Master Alistair?
I'm feeling very weak. I've spent days fighting to ensure that the connection between my spirit and this world wasn't severed.
Well, it's certainly good that you're back. There are a lot of strange things going on.
Our child... is it going to be normal?
This child... Is it really going to be mine and Nate's?
It's not going to have horns or anything, is it? Just because it was conceived by magic?
Yeah, no.
It will be your child. Its birth and life will be just as magical as that of any other child.
They only have horns and stuff if he wished for a child with horns. Wilbur is in the Dark Woods. He wants to find a book which details how the wand may be destroyed.
Wilbur is doing what Remy asked him. He's searching for a book which details how Van Buren's wand can be destroyed.
That wasn't Remy, and the book doesn't tell us how to destroy the wand either. The Van Buren brothers were... We have to stop Munkus and his mad scheme at all costs.
Oh, I know.
Munkus? Aren't the Van Buren's the real problem? They're transforming the whole world bit by bit.
A world which will perish if Munkers gets his hands on the book from the Dark Woods. Quick, hand me my magic wand.
Well, your magic wand,
Well, now. Your magic wand...
You haven't brought it with you, have you?
It must still be in Seastone.
We have to retrieve it immediately. Without it, I can't channel my powers. I feel weaker than ever.
I'll fire up the Mary. Let's go.
Hello, Doc.
Hi, Critter. We've turned the Archmage back to normal. And you won't believe it, but Ivo and me...
You tricked me! Where is the elf?
Hey,
nowhere.
Careful with that thing!
What's going on here?
Uh-oh.
Alistair? This time there'll be no way back!
Ivo!
Come on, Alistair! Or are you gonna carry on hiding behind your friends?
Nate!
Ivo, you have to go, now.
It's the Medusa head.
No, I have to help him.
What exactly are you gonna do?
Gulohahu.
That too.
Mommy, I've made it ever so pretty in there.
Don't worry, my darling. The nice Archmage hasn't got a wand, and he is weak.
Come on, kick her butt. Oh, we're playing as Alistair now? I don't want to fight you. This is much bigger than us.
This is not about you and your little coup d'etat, Mrs.
Coup
Van Buren.
Ha!
There are other powers at work here. Sinister powers.
Which you, of course, will be able to prevent if we let you go, right?
Absolutely.
You don't understand. We are talking about the end of the world.
You'd say anything to save your neck, Alistair.
We will find ourselves in dreadful danger if we don't destroy the magic wand. Yes, that's gonna work.
The wand has to be destroyed. It will lead to untold suffering.
It is the key to power. My power.
Your daughter's power.
Chantal, if we don't destroy the wand, then terrible things will happen.
Don't listen to him.
No, listen to him.
That's right, my little snuggle bunny.
Put that head away before there's another accident.
Put that head away? It's dangerous. There is no known cure for being turned to stone.
That's why no one will dare question my bid for power. The most powerful wand in the world and a head that turns any being of flesh and blood to stone. We have both of Aventasia's most powerful weapons in our hands. No one will be able to stop us!
Mwahaha.
You're right. This has to end here.
You want to stop us?
Whoa. Ooh, he crushed it.
Shoot! We have won!
You have not won. I shall become more powerful than you can possibly imagine.
It's his astral form.
But this is all nonsense. If that's what happened, then I would be... No! What kind of a place do you think this is, Nate?
He's not supposed to be dead, he's just turned stone, right?
Ah!
Well, that was pretty powerful.
Let me go!
You can't help him now.
But we can't just leave him behind.
We have to stop Munkus. Using the temple will open a door to the Nameless One's dungeon dimension.
I couldn't give a shit about this Nameless One. I have to rescue my husband.
Ivo, he's out of our reach.
Is there no hope then?
There's always hope.
Yes, there is. But if the wand does what it was created for, then it will mean the end of all hope. For Nate, for you, and for your child. If you want to rescue him, you have to go to Seastone.
What do I have to do?
I lied to Van Buren. I have no power anymore. It takes all my remaining strength to stay in the land of the living, but soon I will have to leave it.
No!
That is why it's up to all of you to stop Munkus. He must not be allowed to use the machine in the temple.
I will stop him.
Be careful. He is clever, powerful, and prepared to do anything. I will try to warn Wilbur in the Dark Woods. He's been conned and is playing right into the enemy's hands. I don't have much time left. Goodbye, Ivo.
But what shall I do?
Oh. Is he gone, or just still?
I will come back as quickly as I can, and we shall be reunited, my love. Right now, our hope is in Seastone, and with Wilbur in the Dark Woods.
Aww. So is Alistair gone now? Is he still in the Land of the Living, just teleported somewhere else?
Are you sure, Wilbur?
Yes. Some villager will know where old Van Buren lived, and maybe even where we can find the book.
Shouldn't I come with you?
If your feet hurt as much as mine do, then I don't want to do that to you. I won't be gone long. Will you please look after Timmy?
Don't worry, he's sleeping. When you get back, there'll be hot sausages waiting for you.
I can hardly wait. Like a graveyard.
Okay, beginning chapter 5. Stay tuned. We do that. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.